The San Andreas Fault is one of the largest and most important geological faults in the world. Throughout history, it has been the origin of earthquakes that have caused much destruction and have claimed the lives of thousands of people. Today, this place exhibits unusual activity, which some scientists think could indicate the dreaded Big One will occur soon. Where and when could this event occur? Stay with us to find out. What is the San Andreas Fault, and how did it originate? The San Andreas Fault is one of the world's most prominent and studied geological features. This enormous crack runs along approximately 1,300 kilometers throughout California, from Cape Mendocino in North America's Humboldt County to the Sea of Cortez in Baja California, Mexico. This fault marks the boundary between two large tectonic plates, the Pacific Plate and the North American Plate. It is known for its potential to generate large earthquakes. Due to its complex dynamics and impact on the region, it has been the focus of numerous investigations. The origin of the San Andreas Fault dates back to about 15 to 20 million years ago when tectonic plates moved. Tectonic plates are significant fragments of Earth's lithosphere that float above the Earth's upper mantle. Due to convective activity in the mantle, these plates are constantly moving. In the case of the San Andreas Fault, the Pacific Plate moves northwestward relative to the North American Plate at a rate of about 4.6 centimeters per year. This horizontal movement generates enormous tension along the fault, which causes seismic activity. The San Andreas Fault is a classic example of a horizontal slip fault, also known as a strike fault. In this type of fault, the tectonic plates move laterally concerning each other instead of vertically. This lateral movement is the main mechanism that gives rise to earthquakes along the fault. When the accumulated stress exceeds the resistance of the rocks, it is abruptly released in the form of an earthquake. The development of the San Andreas Fault has been a protracted process that began approximately 30 million years ago, when the Pacific Plate began to slide northwesterly in front of the North American Plate. This means that dinosaurs never knew this fault because it arose long after the great extinction of the Cretaceous-Paleogene, during which most dinosaurs became extinct. Before the formation of the fault, the region was dominated by a subduction zone, where the Farallon Plate sank beneath the North American Plate. Over time, the Farallon Plate fragmented and submerged into the mantle, allowing the Pacific Plate to come into direct contact with the North American Plate, forming the San Andreas Fault. Why is this geological fault dangerous? The San Andreas Fault's influence on California's seismic activity is not limited to the region directly adjacent to this. Still, it is also part of a more extensive, complex system of geological faults running through California. The energy released by tectonic movements can trigger a cascade of effects on other nearby faults, such as the Hayward Fault, the Calaveras Fault, or the San Jacinto Fault. This is why if an earthquake is triggered on the San Andreas Fault, it is very likely that it will spread to a wider area. This phenomenon of interaction between faults is known as stress transfer and is a crucial factor in assessing seismic risk in the region. The San Andreas Fault has historically been responsible for some of California's most significant earthquakes. Due to its length and the amount of stress that can accumulate, it is estimated that it can produce earthquakes of up to magnitude 8.0 or higher on the Richter scale. These events have the potential to cause massive destruction and can also affect millions of people living in densely populated urban areas. Past earthquakes due to the San Andreas Fault. Throughout California's history, the San Andreas Fault has been responsible for several major earthquakes, some of which have caused considerable devastation. Some of the most important were: Number 1, 1906 San Francisco Earthquake. This earthquake occurred on April 18th of that year and had an estimated magnitude of 7.9 on the Richter scale. The earthquake caused massive devastation in San Francisco and surrounding areas. It is estimated that more than 3,000 people died as a result of the earthquake and the fires that followed, making it one of the deadliest natural disasters in U.S. history. About 80% of the city was destroyed, and more than 250,000 people were left homeless. This event marked a turning point in understanding and preparing for earthquakes in California and worldwide. Number 2. 1989 Loma Prieta Earthquake. With a magnitude of 6.9 on the Richter scale, this earthquake was caused by a segment of the San Andreas Fault near Monterey Bay. Although the magnitude was less than that of the 1906 earthquake, the Loma Prieta earthquake had a devastating impact, especially in the San Francisco Bay Area. There were 63 confirmed deaths, more than 3,700 injuries, and damages estimated at $6 billion. The collapse of the Nimitz Freeway in Oakland and significant damage to the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge were some of the most prominent effects of the earthquake. Number 3. 1857 Fort Tejon Earthquake. This earthquake had an estimated magnitude of 7.9 on the Richter scale, similar to the 1906 San Francisco earthquake. The epicenter was located near Parkfield, California, and the fault's movement extended for about 350 kilometers. Despite its sheer magnitude, the number of deaths was relatively low, with only two people killed, mainly because the affected area was sparsely populated at the time. However, the earthquake caused significant damage to structures and altered the landscape along the fault. These three examples highlight the destructive potential of the San Andreas Fault. Although some of these earthquakes did not have such a high number on the Richter scale, we must consider that the Richter scale is not the most notable factor in the magnitude of an earthquake. Another important factor is the depth at which the epicenter occurs. Shallow earthquakes, which occur at depths of less than 20 kilometers, tend to be much more destructive because they are so close to the Earth's surface. This means that an earthquake of magnitude 7 on the Richter scale that occurs at a depth of only 15 kilometers can be much more destructive than an 8-scale earthquake at 50 kilometers in depth. Since the San Andreas Fault is a slip fault, the earthquakes associated with it are usually relatively shallow. So, the damage generated by these earthquakes is usually significant compared to others of greater magnitude that occur in other areas of the world. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. When and where will the big one take place? The region's geological history, combined with the patterns of seismic activity observed in the past, suggests that it is only a matter of time before the San Andreas Fault produces another earthquake of great magnitude. This event is often referred to as the Big One and has been a constant concern for seismologists, authorities, and California residents. Historical analysis of earthquakes associated with the San Andreas Fault shows that a large earthquake occurs approximately every 150 to 200 years along specific fault segments. For example, the 1857 Fort Tejon earthquake affected the southern segment of the fault, while the 1906 San Francisco earthquake significantly impacted the northern segment. Since it has been more than 160 years since the Fort Tejon earthquake, and more than 110 years since the San Francisco earthquake, many seismologists believe that the region is entering a critical phase where the fault is accumulating energy in the form of tensile that will eventually be released, causing a major earthquake at any moment. Current predictions suggest that the next major earthquake is likely to occur on the southern segment of the fault, which stretches from the Salton Sea in Southern California to the Los Angeles area. Scientists suspect that the next big earthquake could occur in this region because this segment has been relatively quiet for more than 300 years, which has allowed a significant amount of tension to build up on the tectonic plates. In terms of magnitude, it is estimated that an earthquake in the southern segment of the San Andreas Fault could easily reach a magnitude of between 7.8 and 8.2 on the Richter scale. An earthquake of this magnitude would release an amount of energy equivalent to that of several hundred nuclear bombs, causing an intense shaking that would reach nearby cities such as Los Angeles, San Bernardino, Riverside, and San Diego. The consequences of an earthquake of this magnitude would be devastating. Seismologist models and simulation studies have estimated that tens of thousands of injuries and thousands of deaths could occur. The only way to avoid this is to predict when this event will occur accurately. Unfortunately, determining the exact date of an earthquake is challenging due to the complex and chaotic nature of tectonic processes. However, based on the observed recurrence interval and the time since the last major events, some experts suggest that a large earthquake will likely occur on the southern segment of the San Andreas Fault in the next 30 to 50 years, although it could be even sooner. This means the big one could occur anytime within 30 or 50 years, somewhere in the Salton Sea and the Los Angeles area. How to prepare before this happens? Technology and tectonic models help us better understand the behavior of tectonic plates. However, and despite what many say, all seismologists, geologists, geophysicists, and scientists worldwide agree that modern science does not yet have any technology and no method to predict earthquakes accurately. Although this is worrying, it is not entirely discouraging because, despite being unable to predict earthquakes, we can have a slight approximation of when and where the next one will occur, which will help us prepare ourselves before this occurs. Monitoring seismic activity on the San Andreas Fault is essential to understand patterns better and predict future events. Seismographic stations, satellites, and other geophysical instruments provide valuable data to help scientists identify signs of unusual activity on the fault. In addition, advancements in sensor technology and predictive models can improve the accuracy of predictions and provide more effective alerts. Investment in scientific research is essential to improve earthquake response capacity. This includes developing new materials and technologies for safer building construction and studying the response of different structures and soils to seismic waves. Of course, we need to train more scientists and young enthusiasts with new ideas who can improve all known methods and systems for earthquake monitoring and prevention. Suppose we continue to progress the way we've been doing for generations. In that case, one of the subscribers watching this video may be the enthusiastic scientist who helps develop the technology that allows us to accurately predict when and where the big one will happen. Now, we want to know your opinion. Where do you think the big one will take place? Let us know what you think in the comments.